नमस्कार, आप सभी का स्वागत है। मैं हूं राहुल और आप देख रहे हैं पीएम ई विद्या चैनल्स और एनसीईआरटी ऑफिशियल। हम लेकर हाजिर हैं अपना अगला मैथ्स का लाइव इंटरैक्टिव सेशन लेकर, जो है क्लास 9th का। एंड वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री पार्ट 1। वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दिस टॉपिक ऑफ क्लास 9th, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। और जब मैथमेटिक्स की बात होती है तो कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री एक ऐसी ज्योमेट्री की क्लास, एक ऐसी मैथ्स का टॉपिक जिसको आप यदि समझ लिया आपने तो आपके मार्क्स 100 में से 100, यानी कि वहां तो नंबर कटने का कोई स्कोप ही नहीं है। तो आइए हम प्रयास करते हैं अच्छे स्कोर लाने के लिए, समझने का प्रयास पहले करते हैं। सो आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट अ गेस्ट, मिस उषा पिल्ले फ्रॉम कैंपियन स्कूल भोपाल। उषा जी नमस्कार, गुड आफ्टरनून एंड अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम इन द सेशन।
गुड आफ्टरनून।
आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट यू टू प्लीज बिगिन योर टॉपिक कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री, एंड वी आर वेरी होपफुल दैट दिस सेशन विल बी वेरी बेनिफिशियल फॉर ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स एंड द व्यूअर्स ऑफ आवर प्रोग्राम।
यस, good afternoon students. In the last class we are already studied about polynomials, and polynomials we have studied algebraic identities and all the theorems and applications of these theorems. And moving on the next chapter, coordinate geometry, today we can understand what are the important points related to this coordinate geometry. First is, in coordinate geometry we have to understand about a plane surface. A plane surface, that means a flat surface that extends all the four sides infinitely, is called a Cartesian plane. This plane surface is known as Cartesian plane, and we can have so many examples: the surface of a board, the surface of a wall, etc., etc. So it is divided into four equal parts. Each part is called a quadrant. So Cartesian plane is divided into four equal parts. Each part is called a quadrant. And we can note this number of quadrants in anti-clockwise direction. They are the first quadrant, second, third, and fourth. And it is divided by a horizontal line called x-axis and a vertical line called y-axis. And we already learned about, in a Cartesian plane, on x-axis, right side of x-axis and above the x-axis, positive numbers are given. And on left side and below the x-axis, negative numbers are given. So how can we find the points in which quadrant or not? So in first quadrant, we are having x-axis positive numbers and y-axis positive. So we can have the points plus plus, that is positive, positive values will be here. And on second quadrant, x-axis negative numbers and y-axis positive. So we can see minus plus. In the quadrant 3, there are minus and minus. On x-axis and y-axis, both negative signs. So we can say minus, minus points will be here. And in fourth quadrant, x-axis positive and y-axis negative. So plus minus sign will come. So here, totally, a Cartesian plane is divided into four equal parts. Each part is called a quadrant, and the quadrant we can number it by anti-clockwise direction, and it is divided by a horizontal line called x-axis and vertical line called y-axis. Now moving on to next, the intersecting point of this x-axis and y-axis. Here you can see the intersecting point. It is called origin. And the coordinates of origin is 0, 0, because the on x-axis also 0 is the point, and y-axis also 0. So the coordinates of origin is 0, 0. So what is meant by coordinate? Here on x-axis we are given a point A and on y-axis B. Together we can write the point A, B. Because always first we will write the point from x-axis and then we will write the point from y-axis. So this A, B point together we can call it as coordinates, that is points together from x-axis and y-axis is called a coordinate. Here we are given a point A, B, then A is from x-axis, that is x-coordinate is called abscissa. And y coordinate is called ordinate. We can understand what is abscissa and ordinate from this coordinate points. So, what is a coordinate? Points together from x-axis and y-axis is called a coordinate. and here x coordinate is called abscissa and y coordinate is called ordinate. Now these are the important points given in this chapter. So by using these properties and definitions, we can move on to the questions. So here the first question is, from the given graph, write the following. First, we have to find the coordinates of point A, B and C. How can we find the coordinates? We can see point A is in the first quadrant and the point from x-axis is 3 and y-axis is 2. So together the points from x-axis and y-axis is a coordinate, and we can write the coordinates of A as 3, 2. Now the second point B, where it lies, we can see in the positive x-axis. Positive x-axis mein dekho, 4, that is, that lies on x-axis. X-axis mein hai toh y point kya hoga? 0. So we can write this point B as 4, 0. Now the third point lies on positive y-axis, that is also at 4. But x-axis the point is 0. So we can write the coordinate as 0, 4. That means a point lies on x-axis, always y is 0, and a point lies on y-axis, always x coordinate is 0. Now the next question is, the point identified by the coordinates minus 1, 1, where it lies, see, minus 1 from x-axis and 1 from y-axis. This point lies on the second quadrant. Minus is in the second quadrant. And what is the point given? Named D. So this point is D minus 1, 1. The third point is, third question is, the abscissa of the point E. E is on first quadrant. The point from x-axis is 2 and y-axis is 3. Together we can see the coordinates of E as 2, 3. We have already studied about abscissa. What is abscissa? X coordinate is called abscissa, and always we are noting point from the x-axis first. So abscissa of point E is 2. Now the last is ordinate of the point F. F lies on the third quadrant, means the point is minus minus. From x-axis minus 4 and from y-axis minus 3. So the coordinates are minus 4, minus 3. Now what about ordinate? The y coordinate is known as ordinate, and here the point y is minus 3. That is, ordinate of the point F is minus 3. In this way we can find the coordinates and also the points lies on the quadrants. Now moving on, next question. In which quadrant or on which axis do each of the following points minus 2, 4, 3, minus 1, minus 1, 0, 1, 2 and minus 3, minus 5 lie? First we have to write in which quadrant this lies. According to the signs we can say very easily. Then we have to verify this by locating them on Cartesian plane. Now first point is minus 2, 4. We know minus plus is lies on second quadrant. So we can write it as in the second quadrant. First is 3 minus 1 plus minus, that will lies on the fourth quadrant. Minus 1, 0. When minus 1 is given in x-axis, the point lies on x-axis, that is on negative side. So we can say it is on negative x-axis. 1, 2, both are positive, means it is in the first quadrant. And minus 3, minus 5, both are negative, means it is in the third quadrant. Now we can look at these points. So first point is minus 2, 4 from x-axis minus 2 and on y-axis 4. So minus 2, 4 is in the second quadrant. Now 3 minus 1, 3 on the x-axis and minus 1 is here. So it is in the fourth quadrant. We are verifying it. Now the third point is minus 1, 0. It is on the x-axis. We are already written negative x-axis. Now the fourth one is 1, 2. Both are positive. We can see x-axis 1 and y is 2. So 1, 2 on the first quadrant. And the last point is minus 3, minus 5. Both negative on earth button, x-axis minus 3 and y-axis minus 5. So both the points are given in the third quadrant itself. So in this way, we can plot the points and write the quadrants, or we can first write the quadrants and verify in which quadrants these points lie. Now the third question is, without plotting the points, indicate the quadrant in which point these points will lie. If ordinate is minus 3 and axis is minus 2, we are already learned, for writing a coordinate, first we have to write abscissa. Here abscissa is minus 2 and ordinate is minus 3. So the coordinate is minus 2 comma minus 3. We can say this lies on which quadrant? Both are negative. Dono negative hai toh kaunsi quadrant mein hai? That is in the third quadrant. We are already studied about the signs related to the quadrants. Both points are negative, so it lies in the third quadrant. Next one is abscissa is 5 and ordinate is minus 6. So the coordinate is 5 comma minus 6, and plus minus is given, so it lies in the fourth quadrant. So in this way, if we are given abscissa and ordinate, we can write the coordinates, and also we can find the number of quadrants in which quadrant it lies. Now the next question is, find the coordinates of the point which lies both on x-axis and y-axis. Can you say which point lies on x-axis and y-axis both? That is the origin itself. Origin is 0, 0. That is the same point from x-axis and y-axis. So we can say the point lies on both x-axis and y-axis is origin itself, and the coordinates are 0, 0. Now, second part is, whose abscissa is 5 and lies on x-axis. Suppose a point lies on x-axis, always the equation is y equal to 0. So the y coordinate is 0 and the abscissa is given. So we can write the coordinates as 5, 0. Now, next is, whose coordinate is minus 4 and lies on y-axis. If the point lies on y-axis, what will be the equation? Y-axis ki point ki equation kya hoga? X is equal to 0. And x is equal to 0, we can start with x for writing a coordinate. That is 0, minus 4 will be the point or coordinate. Without giving graph also, we can do this type of questions. Now the next one is, plot the following points and check whether they are collinear or not. Okay. The points are 0, 0, 0, 2, 2, 5, 5. So what is meant by collinear points? You are studied in 6th class. Collinear points means points which lies on the same line are called collinear points. We have to check the points lies on the same line or not. Okay. So first we have to plot the points. That is 0, 0. That is the origin itself. Mm-hmm. And this point. Yes.
Right, please.
Next point is 2, 2. That is A, 2, mm-hmm. 2. Both are positive, so it is in the first quadrant. And the point is 5, 5. So by joining these three points, we get a straight line.
Yes.
So all the points lies on the same line. So we can say these given points are collinear. That means, if the points lies on a straight line, we can say the points are collinear. And if they are not lying on the same line, we can say it is non-collinear.
Okay.
And we can give an example of non-collinear points as vertices of a triangle. Triangle, three different points are given and they are not lying on a straight line. So we can say they are non-collinear points.
So this would be the condition of, to check collinear line.
Yes.
All right.
Now, in this case, find the perpendicular distance of a point P 5,7 from the y-axis. We can see the point lies. It is not necessary to draw a graph, only to show you this drawn. The point 5 from x-axis and 7 from y-axis. So, point is noted as 5,7. Now, the question is perpendicular distance of this point from the y-axis. Can you see this is y-axis? And how much distance is this point from y-axis? Is 5 units. So we can say 5 units. Suppose the same question is given to us. What is the perpendicular distance of this point from x-axis? Because this is x-axis. X-axis is deep, 7 units ki distance. So we can say the perpendicular distance of the point from x-axis are 7 units. Here, distance from y-axis is given as 5 units.
Okay.
Now the next one is, if the coordinates of two points are given, we have to find abscissa of P minus abscissa of Q. How can we find? First, abscissa is x coordinate of a point. X coordinate means first point. Okay. First point P ke kya hai? -2.
-2.
Q ke first point hai? -3. So we can subtract these two. So abscissa of P minus abscissa of Q is -2 minus of -3. Okay. What is minus of -3? Already you have studied it in integers. Minus of -3 plus.
Yes.
So we can write it as -2 + 3 = 1. In this way, we can find the difference between the abscissa or the difference between the coordinates.
Okay.
So next is, write the equation of x-axis and then y-axis. Suppose a point lies on x-axis. Just now I explained about that. Point lies on x-axis. Suppose x is 2. So the, in y-axis, that will be 0. So we can say the equation for x-axis is y equal to 0. And the equation of y-axis is x is equal to 0. Now, next is plot the points A, 5, 5 and B, -5, 5 in the Cartesian plane. Join AB, OA and OB. Name the type of triangle so obtained. Now, here we are given the points A, 5, 5. That is on first quadrant, both points are positive from x-axis 5 and y-axis also 5. So we can say both the points are from x-axis and y-axis are positive. It lies on first quadrant. Now second point is B, -5, 5, -5 from x-axis and 5 from y-axis. That is in the second quadrant it lies. The third point is origin. So origin means 0, 0. Now join AB, OA and OB. Now, what can we say about the triangle? These two sides, OB and OA, are of same distance. When two sides of a triangle are of equal measure, we can say it is an isosceles triangle. Suppose we are given all the three sides are of equal measure, then what can we say about the triangle? It is an equilateral triangle. And all the sides are different, then it is a scalene triangle. Already you have studied this also about different types of triangles. If all the three sides are equal, it is an equilateral triangle. If two sides of a triangle are equal, then it is an isosceles triangle. All the three sides are different, then it is a scalene triangle. And suppose the question is to check, is it a right triangle or not? Then we can see the longest side, -5 to +5, that is distance cannot be negative, so this is 10. And we can find the square of this side, 10 square, and the other two sides are also given. We can find the sum of the squares of the other two sides. And if the square of the longest side is equal to the sum of the squares of other two sides, then we can say it is a right triangle. So many type of questions related to this triangle can come in the picture. Now the first question is, write the coordinates of the vertices of a rectangle whose length and breadth are 7 and 4 units respectively. One vertex at the origin, the longer side lies on the x-axis, and one of the vertices lies in the third quadrant. Now, what can we say about the rectangle? Opposite, what are the properties of a rectangle? Properties of rectangles are opposite sides of the rectangle are equal and parallel. Let's say all the angles are of 90 degree. Now, here length and breadth measure is given. One vertex at the origin. We can see this is the origin. And the one of the vertex lies on the third quadrant, means both the points will be negative. And distance length is equal to 7 units, means we can take this distance from origin to A as minus 7. So this point is minus 7, 0. And the breadth given is 4 units. From here, if we are drawing this point on the third quadrant, 4 units means that will also be minus 4. That is minus 7, minus 4. Now, we have to find the fourth quadrant from origin, 4 units distance related to third quadrant, that is 0, minus 4. Now, by joining these points AB and BC, we got this rectangle ABCD. So, the vertices or coordinates of this rectangle are A, minus 7, 0, B, minus 7, minus 4, C, 0, minus 4, and O, 0, 0. Suppose we are given this rectangle and we have to find the area of this rectangle. What is the formula for finding area of a rectangle? That is length into breadth. How much is the length? We are given this length as 7 and breadth as 4. So, we can multiply 7 into 4. We will get answer as 7 4s are 28 square units. Now, as a conclusion, we can see about this coordinate geometry. First, I told about what is this plane surface called. This plane surface is called a Cartesian plane. It is divided into 4 equal parts. This part is called a quadrant. And a quadrant, we can note it by anticlockwise sign. This is first quadrant, second, third, and fourth. Here, the signs of the points are positive and positive, and minus and plus. Here it is minus minus, and this one is plus minus. So, next, this is divided by a horizontal line called x-axis and a vertical line called y-axis, and the intersecting point of x-axis and y-axis is called origin, and the coordinates of origin are 0, 0.
Okay.
Now, if we are taking a point on any quadrant, minus 7, minus 4, together it is known as a coordinate, and the x coordinate is known as minus 7, that is known as abscissa, and the y coordinate is known as ordinate, that is minus 7 is abscissa and minus 4 is ordinate.
Right. Usha ji, I would request you to please conclude this session. We have hardly 30 seconds for you.
Yes.
So, why would you please conclude?
Yes. As a conclusion, we can plot the points and find the shapes of the triangles, rectangles, or any type of polygon. And you are already studied in 8th class for finding the area of different types of polygons. If it is a pentagon, if it is a rectangle, if it is a parallelogram, any of the figure is given, you can find the area also by plotting the points and joining the points. We get different types of polygons. Mm-hmm. In the next class, we will discuss about how to find the area of these types of polygons after plotting these points. And okay. also we can find in which quadrants this lies. Is it a rectangle? Is it a square or a right angle triangle? Find the coordinate or vertices we have to find if it is given an equilateral triangle. All these things, next class we will discuss about in the remaining part.
Right. So, looking forward for the next session as the conclusion, as the successor part of this session. Thank you very much, Usha ji, aap judi, and you have explained this coordinate geometry session very well for the students. Ye session YouTube par upload hoga, aur aap wahan par ise zarur dekh payenge. So, you can watch this video later on, video lecture of this class 9, coordinate geometry. Thank you, Usha ji, for joining us. Thanks for this session. हमारा ये मैथ्स का सेशन हम यहीं समाप्त करते हैं और अगला सेशन लेकर हम अभी हाजिर होंगे. देखते रहिए PM E विद्या चैनल्स और NCERT ऑफिशियल. नमस्कार.